About social consciousness, it's happening right now because the universe is trying to restore its balance. So the fact that we're here, we're talking about this, this is us, you know, with the young people, we're doing this, we're having a dialogue. So social consciousness is people coming together to want to awaken themselves and others. Mm-hmm. So I'm adamant about it. I'm very passionate about it. I think it's very important that we start to have these dialogues. So yeah, just the awakening of the people.
To be socially conscious, you have to want to be aware of what's going on around you. You have to want to have a grip on reality, because if you don't, like, it's just gonna pass you by. Mm-hmm. So I think it starts with us and these kinds of dialogues, people wanting to be awake.
Do you think it's conditional? Or at a certain age, with maturity, you tend to then open your eyes?
There's some things you're not going to be able to understand simply because you saw a 30-second news clip or you read an article. There's some things you have to experience firsthand, and you have to be there and see it with your own eyes and touch it yourself. Mm-hmm. And some of these things aren't even tangible. It's just something that, mm-hmm. it's like I said, some things you just have to be there to experience. That's a start. Like the news, they'll tell you about things, but I mean, you're not getting the 100%. Like I said, you can watch a TV. You can watch the news, you can read your articles, but I mean, sometimes you really got to get in the trenches and get that information for yourself. I don't really trust anybody's information except the information I dig up.
I think it all starts with self-love.
Yeah.
Honestly,
yeah.
Like, at first I thought everybody tried to make me, you know, yes, me, love yourself more. I'm like, no, I don't want to. You don't want to love other people. But like, once I actually understood what it actually meant, because by going within myself, I'm able to realign everything, you know, to heal myself. And then once I'm straight, you know, I can impact more people.
And I'm still learning to love myself. Mm-hmm. I love myself. Mm-hmm. I love myself so much more than I did a couple years ago, you know? Mm-hmm. And I'm excited to keep learning how to love myself. Yeah, it really is fun.
I really love it.
But it took a while. It's a long process.
It's a long grueling process. It's just like sometimes you don't even see like what is my end game. Like, why am I even putting myself through this? But when you do it, it's just like once you finally do get it, like once the light bulb finally does come on, it's like, okay, I love myself. Now I want to share this with someone.
Yeah. Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? Like, I fall in love with myself, and then I want to share what that experience is like with other
people. I want to heal people from within, you know?
Right.
So, what was I about to say about that? Just digress. Like, you know, brain fart.
We don't necessarily have to put the younger generation through what we did, because we have the opportunity, and we know kind of younger. Oh. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
What's my parents?
And I think, furthermore, it's important to, if you're gonna give someone like criticism, like make it constructive.
Yeah.
If you're gonna tell someone that they're doing something wrong, don't just tell them that's wrong, don't do this, don't do that. Tell them what they should be doing right. It's not something you can sit down and put on paper
and think it out.
Yeah, it's not. Like, it's never that simple. You're gonna have to add some variables into your function. Like, it's complicated.
Yeah.
Like, shit isn't that simple.
And I think knowing that right there is being socially conscious.
Exactly.
Knowing that, because you have to understand that you may not know everything.
That's the first step. Right.
You have to accept that it's shit out there that you don't know. Right?
Yeah.
And to know that you will spend your entire, if you're open to it, you'll spend your entire life learning. But to me, that's so exciting.
People want to look at, they want to stay in the box, but sometimes you gotta jump out the box, you know?
Yeah. See, Kayla, you don't know everything.
Right.
You do not know everything. Even when you think you know, sometimes I can be like, wait.
Artist, I think that's part of what makes being an artist so so special and so unique for every person, because that's not something that everyone is able to do. Mm-hmm. How many people that can resonate with?
Yeah.
And you can build those like instant connections with people simply because you think the same way.
Yeah.
I think that's something that's really dope.
Like a chameleon, I blended into my wallpaper and my bed sheets. Filthy with stardust on my lips, I was mesmerized by the galaxy that is you, and you coursed through my bloodstream like heroin. We were high as hell off of each other, kind of like three sheets in the wind. We told lies that our contorted limbs foolishly believed as our hearts sent signals in opposite directions. And all that mattered in that moment was that we were numb to our pain and we had passion to spare, even though we both knew the pleasure came with an expiration date. It's like every time we finished painting the room with our promises to get up when it was over, I wasn't sure whether to choke you or roll you up in my blunt and smoke you.
Thanks for checking out Social Consciousness. We hope that you join us on our next episode. In the meantime, you can check out Souls and Substance on soulsandsubstance.tumblr.com, or you can also search Souls and Substance on facebook.com as well. We'll see you next time. Thanks for joining.